Do you agree or you disagree with Gayton McKenzie when he says the DA pushed the ANC too far, right? A lot of us guys might remember that look, the things that were said by EDA and everything. Yeah, a lot of us might remember that the DA buffet. But nevertheless, yeah, we'll need to talk about what Gayton McKenzie said that what he meant when he said that the DA has pushed the ANC too far. On the other hand, we need to talk about MK political party. MK political party wants the case against the IEC official arrested for contravening local electoral act handled firmly, right? Musa Wenkosi Mnikati, an IEC area manager at Imbali in Pietermaritzburg, was officially criminally charged in the dock on Thursday, right? I did a story about that and I told you that there's an IEC official that has been charged concerning that. And so look, MK party, they are reacting to that to say we want to set an example about this one. We want to, I don't know how best can I say this, but yeah, they are saying, I don't know how best can I say this, but they are saying that, you know what? The more I think about the situation, it's the more I think, I said to myself, party, IEC officials, IEC itself, why will you employ members of the, why will you employ ANC people to come and oversee such elections? Why would you do that? But they did it anyway, right? If you ask me, why wouldn't you subscribe to this YouTube channel? I wouldn't know. Since I wouldn't know, please do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so where do we start? Let's start with Indaba ye MK party. MK party have said the following. Bathi MK party ET. Umkhonto wesizwe party in KwaZulu-Natal, Moses Mabhida region, has called for the court to be firm when handling the case of an Electoral Commission of South Africa, IEC official, arrested for contravening the Electoral Act. Then they say, Musa Wenkosi Mnikati, an IEC area manager at Imbali in Pietermaritzburg, was officially criminally charged in the dock as of now, from yesterday, Thursday. He's accused of illegally transporting ballot boxes during the voting period in May. The MK party says the arrest spoke to the many irregularities related to the recent elections, right? Why was he transporting that? Because it's not allowed? But by the way, it has been said that he's facing somewhere around 10 years in prison just for that act. It's considered to be a very serious thing, contravening that it's a serious offense. So he's looking around somewhere there. MK Party says, we are vindicated as MK Party about the ruling. We strongly believe that it's not just an electoral misconduct, but it is a criminal offense and it should be treated as such, said MK Party. We believe that the court has as it props the accused, will reveal more names as to who instructed the accused to commit such a criminal offense or such a criminal act. Did you just hear that? On the other hand, the Patriotic Alliance leader, Mr. Gayton, Mr. Gayton McKenzie, Uthi, Government of National Unity, GNU, partner Gayton McKenzie of the Patriotic Alliance, PA, believes that they pushed the ANC too far in the cabinet power-sharing negotiations, which resulted in President Ramaphosa rejecting some of the Blue Party demands. Ramaphosa wrote a letter to DA leader John Steenhuisen on the 25th of June, in which he described the DA's demands as legally incompetent with regards to their interest in Director General Port of Department. DA Federal Chairperson Helen Zille wanted her party to have at least 12 ministerial positions, including Steenhuisen taking Paul Mashatile's deputy president position. DA. Hi, God. Hi, I'm defeated. DA has defeated me. But here's the thing. Uthi Gayton McKenzie, the negotiations have been stalling because the two biggest parties in the government, looking at GNU, are unable to find each other on how many ministerial positions should be allocated to the DA by the ANC. It has been up and down, with a lot of leaked letters. I do think the latest letter from the president, that is, Lukasekas is leaving down, and we are close to a solution or agreement in the GNU, right? Yeah. So what's your take about the fact that they are saying EDA Nayo, they've pushed the ANC too far? What's your take with such sentiment? Personally, I will say that the EDA here behaves itself as a founding member because of such privileges, according to DA. Because of such, it insinuates that because of its position being a founding member here, it must then benefit a lot. That's what DA is. Those are sentiments that you will get from EDA, that it ought to benefit a lot from everything that is transpiring in the government, the government of national unity. It sees itself as an organization that is supposed to, that's the DA. They see themselves as an organization that is supposed to, how best can I describe them? Because I'm looking at a best fitting description. But like here, they are playing a role of being a principal. You know what I'm saying? Everything and anything that happens in the GNU, it must first begin and it will lastly end with them. Who's coming in and which positions are to be shared? They want that, nothing more, nothing less. That's the TA for you. We have seen them with such a personality in the government of national unity. But again, the questions that shall remain unanswered is, Benia PANC beniofunan vele, because uko benje TANC ayanga lapha all these problems ngaba wekho namhlanje, right? There would have been peace, people would have been enjoying their lives wherever they are. But because DA, because of ANC going into bed with DA, these are the outcome of going into bed with your enemy.